How do you read this? Is it chi or ki? Ciao a tutti! We are looking at pronouncing and writing the letter C in Italian. It's a little tricky, so let's get right into it and see how we can be done by the end of this very short lesson. You will know how to read words with C and not make the traditional mistake that most English speakers make. So, as you know, the consonant C has two sounds. It can sound k, k, or ch, ch. Now, the way I'm representing these sounds, it's not the official phonetic way of representing. I'm just using English letters. So whenever you see those brackets, I'm using English alphabet to tell you that's the sound that we're going for, like k or ch. When it comes to k, we can have five options because we have five vowels and k combines with all vowels. So we have ka, ke, ki, ko, ku. You have been saying that if you've been doing your drill that I recommend, there's no problem here. Ka, ke, ki, ko, ku, not that difficult, right? Ka, ke, ki, ko, ku, there are sounds that you can utter, like it's not that complicated. When it comes to the ch sound, again, it's easy. Cha, che, chi, cho, chu. I don't think you find it difficult. Cha, che, chi, cho, chu. I'm telling you, you have to put the ch sound and then put the vowels. So cha, che, chi, cho, chu. The real problem is the spelling, but the main point of this lesson is the reading, because I doubt that you'll be doing a lot of writing in Italian, even when you become more fluent, unless you exchange emails and messages with your friends. But the problem of the spelling of C is that as a learner of Italian, you will read a lot of Italian. One, because you're reading books or exercises, or because you're in Italy and you're reading menus and you're reading stuff that it's, you know, posters. And that's when it becomes a problem. You need to know how to read the spelling of C, and here it goes. Let's start with the k sound. So C is pronounced k when it comes before a, o, and u. So a, o, u, k. So we have ka, ko, ku. So here's some examples of words that you already know. Casa, home. Casa, cosa, thing, or what. Cuore, cuore means heart, cuore. So as you can see, CA sounds casa, but your instinct would know that. You wouldn't look at that and say chaza, right? There's no way. So this context is actually the easiest because your instinct will know what to do. Casa, cosa, cuore, because see you, what else, how else would you read it? Even as an English speaker, cu. So that's not too difficult, so cuore. So banca or banco. Again, very straightforward, not too complicated. I don't see a problem here for you. Now, I told you that we can have the sound ke and ki, but that's when it gets a little tricky because we change the spelling when we want a k sound before a and e. You will understand why later, but the way we spell ke is c-h-a, ke, and ki is c-h-i, ke and ki. That's because we don't have the k consonant in Italian. So if we did, we would just put K and E and we'd be done, but CH is our way of maintaining the K sound before those two vowels, A and E. And in a minute, you will see why we need to do this, all right? But that's when English speakers usually mess it up. You look at CHA and you say CHE, but that's not, it's K. You see CHI and you say CHI, but no, it's KI. So that's going to be a little bit of a recurring problem unless today we're fixing it. We need to add the H because we need to maintain the k sound of that consonant. Ke, that or what. Ki, who. Chiesa, church. Chiesa, chiesa. Bruschetta, bruschetta. That's the toasted bread with stuff on top, right? So bruschetta. You see C-H-A? That's ke. It's always ke. It never changes. It's always ke. Don't be tempted to pronounce it something else because C-H-A is ke. Imagine a CH is a transformed K. Imagine a K and it's transformer and it transforms into CH. Like it's mutation of K into CH. Macchina. What's happening here? We have the key of that CHI, key, but there's a double C before. So when we have a double C, all we're doing is making the K stronger. We're not changing the sound. It's just stronger. Macchina. Macchina. We've worked with this word a lot. Chiave, key, chiave. How about this one? Well, we said that CH sounds key, So we have schiena, and then we just put a s before. So schiena, schiena, schiena. That means back, the back of your body. And I understand that chiesa, bruschetta, and schiena could be a little tricky to the eye. But now that you know, you're not going to make that mistake again, even when you see other words that have the same combination of sounds, because Italian is consistent. So if you learn it once, it's going to be consistent in every other word. Now, let's look at the C consonant with the sound CH. I said that we have CHA, CHE, CHI, CHA, CHU. But how do we spell it? In English, you do CH to create the CH sound, but we can't do that in Italian because CH, we already established that it means K. It's another way of spelling K when we need it. So we cannot use CH because consistency, right? So how would we spell CH? So we're still going to have to rely on the C consonant, but we have to get creative. But here's the beauty. It's going to sound CH when it precedes A and E, the two vowels that before weren't included. So if it precedes A, O, and U, it sounds K, and if it precedes A and E, it sounds CH. So those two combinations are standard CHE and CHI. This is how you say CHE and CHI, or how you spell CHE and CHI in Italian. Here's another tip. I think it's going to come later, but I'll tell you now. Basically, if your English speaking instinct would read that word that you're looking at, as a S sound, like Sicily. See that CI? That's your instinct is would read that Sicily, like that Sicily. So if your English instinct looks at a word and says, oh, I'm going to pronounce it S, remember that the C consonant doesn't have that pronunciation. It's either CH or K. So when your instinct says, oh, it's S, then you know it's CH in Italian. Basically, that's a little trick that I have developed that I've never heard anybody teach, but it works. There you go. First one. Your English brain would say cinema. Guess what that is in Italian? Cinema. Cinema. That's, I think there's an actor with that last name or something like that. That's cena. Cena in Italian. It's a CH sound because your instinct would be cena. Cena. This one is the word for chickpeas or garbanzo beans. Ceci. Ceci. You know, think of the name Cecile. That's how you spell it in English. If your instinct is change it to CH and you're sorted. Ceci. Ceci. And then the classic arrivederci. Arrivederci. Goodbye. Baci. Baci. Kisses. Also the chocolates. Cina. The country. Cina. Cina. So that was CH. Easy spelling. You put it before an A and E and it sounds CH. But how are we going to spell it when I want to create CHA, CHO, and CHU? You know we have the sounds because you heard the word CHAO. You know we have the word CHOCCOLATA. So how do we spell CHA, CHO, and CHU? And that's when we do a little trick that is kind of breaking the idea that we pronounce all the letters in Italian. Because that combination of letters, C-I-A, it's pronounced CHA. CHA. In most cases, there are times when we would pronounce it CHIA, but those are exception words, and I want you to kind of not think about those, and think about CIA is one sound, CHA. It's not CHIA, it's CHA. That's CHO, or CHO, 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 and CHU, CHU. So, CHAO. It's not CHIAO, it's CHAO, CHAO. CHURMA. CHURMA is the crew of a boat. Strange word, actually. CHURMA. Strange sounding to me as an Italian. CHU. It's not CHIURMA. CHURMA. ARANCIA. ARANCIA, that's an orange. CHOCCOLATA. CHOCCOLATA, chocolate. ARANCIONE. ARANCIONE is the color orange. ARANCIONE. BACIO. BACIO is a single kiss. So if we were to summarize how we spell the K sound in the five options, that's it. KA, KE, KI, KO, KU. KA, stand, no H. KE and KI, you need the H. Why? Because if we didn't have the H there, it would sound CHE and CHI. And that is why we got to do something to make it not sound CHE and CHI. And we thought, oh, we got a letter that doesn't do anything in this language. Let's put H there. So KE and KI fixes the problem. KA, KE, KI, KO, and KU. No problem there. To have the CH sound, then it's a little more different. It's a little bit more complicated. So we got CHA. We got to have the I. Why? Because without the I, that would sound CA. Italian is consistent and straightforward. We got to do something. Let's throw a vowel. Oh, Can we throw an H there? No, 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 no. CH, we don't like that. CHA, we don't like it. Because CH sounds good. That's why we're not using it. So that's cha. Che, that's how C would sound naturally, because your instinct in English would make it sound like a S. So you know it's che and chi. And then for cho and chu, we got to throw the I back in so that it sounds cho and chu instead of ko and ku. So here's the trick that I was mentioning. If your instinct as an English speaker would pronounce that C as a S, like the word cinema and century, then we're gonna be ch sounds in Italian. So how about the sh sound? Do we have a letter for the sh sound? No, we do not. In English, it's spelled in many cases as a CH. That's why I got it there. But the sound sh, how does Italian accomplish that sound? Very interesting. We add an S consonant before chi and che. And this gives us a whole new combination of really confusing looking words. So we have the word cena. That's cena. If we add S before, we have scena. That is how, so S and C followed by I or E, that's important. So basically the ch sound preceded by S becomes sh. So cena, scena. These are two unrelated words, but they have the same spelling except for the S, right? Cina means China, and scimmia, which is S-C-I, scimmia is monkey, so scimmia. But of course, C-S-C-I and S-C-E doesn't cover the whole range of sha, she, shi, sho, shu. And guess what? We have those five, sha, she, shi, sho, shu. So how would you spell sha? Ta-da! There you go. We take the cha spelling and we add S to make it into sha, sha. She, we already looked at that. She, pretty straightforward. Sho is basically the word cho with the S consonant, sho. And chu preceded by S becomes shu, shu. For example, sharpa. Sharpa is a scarf. Sharpa. Spelled S-C-I-A, right? Sciopero. Sciopero. We learned this word in the past. It's a strike. Sciopero. Scendere. Scendere means to go down. Scendere. Capisci? Do you understand? Capisci. That's sh because it's spelled that way. So if we add S before a ch sound and it becomes a sh, what happens when we add S before a k sound? Nothing happens. We have CU sounds ku, put an S, it's scuola, scuola, scala, stairs. Bruschetta, we saw that earlier, which is a bit tricky sometimes because I know that in English-speaking countries, sometimes it's pronounced a different way, but in Italian, it's pronounced bruschetta, bruschetta. Schiena, that's the back of your body. So let's review what we've learned. Actually, give you some tips. C consonant in Italian never sounds S. It's either ch or k. When your instinct tells you that it should sound like S, because you're an English speaker, then make the ch sound, basically. In Italian, CH is the equivalent of K. So every time you see CH, imagine a transformation into a K so that it sounds K, so we got ki and K. I is silent in those combos most of the time. There will be words that, again, like I said, will pronounce it, but in most cases, it's silent and it's only there to tell you that the ch is happening and not the k sound. And that's all for today. Lots of practice in the unit associated with this lesson, obviously, on Beginner Italian Level 1 on our platform, plus a bunch of other activities, including dictation exercises and comprehension videos in Italian. I will see you tomorrow for a lesson where we look at the spelling and for the reading for the consonant G. G is tricky as well. A domani. Ciao, ciao.